Welcome students, I hope you all are doing fine. I'm glad to have you all back in another fruitful session of learning through videos. Today we are going to study about gas laws. Before studying about the laws which are followed by all gases, let us study about the behavior of gases as explained by kinetic theory. Now the first point is, the gases are made up of tiny particles which move in all possible directions and in all possible speeds. Number two, volume of gases is negligible as compared to the volume of the container in which gases are kept. Number three, gases have neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape. Number four, gases exert pressure in all directions. Number five, gases are highly compressible. Number six, gases are highly diffusible, or you can also say expansible. Number seven, gases have low densities. And the last one, gases mix with one another to form a homogeneous mixture. Now there is a term called diffusion. What is diffusion? It is the intermixing of two or more gases when kept in contact to form a homogeneous mixture. Now you all have studied in your previous classes that the intermolecular space in gases is the largest, and the intermolecular force of attraction between the gas molecules is the least. So it was just a revision. Now before learning the gas laws, it's very important to know the three entities which are associated to gas laws. The first one is temperature. The second one is pressure, and the third one is volume. Now, a small change in any one of these entities bring about a significant change in the other two. That is why all gases behave in a certain manner, and these have been framed into laws by scientists. Now, let us take up these entities one by one. Now, what is temperature? It is the indicator of the average kinetic energy possessed by a molecule. I repeat, it is the indicator of the average kinetic energy possessed by a molecule. Now, when you raise the temperature of a gas or any other substance, all the molecules, they gain kinetic energy and they start moving at a random speed, higher than the previous speed. And we say that the temperature is increased. Or in other words, the average kinetic energy of a particle is directly proportional to its temperature. Now, it is measured either in Celsius, degree Celsius, or Kelvin. About this Kelvin scale, I will explain when I teach Charles' law. For now, you just remember that Kelvin, 1 Kelvin is equal to degree Celsius plus 273. I will be explaining about the entire Kelvin scale or the absolute scale in my next video. Now, what is pressure of a gas? It is the average force exerted by bombardment of gas molecules on the walls of the container per unit area. You all must have studied in physics, pressure is force per unit area. Now, what is this force? The force exerted by the bombardment of the gas molecules on the walls of the container. Now, you know, gas molecules, they keep on randomly colliding with each other and to the walls of the container. Now, this force per unit area of the container gives the pressure of the gas. Now, pressure, what are the units of pressure? Now, pressure is measured in the length of mercury column, either cm of mercury column or millimeter of mercury column. Hg is mercury. There is another unit called torr, in short, or torricelli after the name of the scientist. It is also measured in atmospheres. For example, one atmosphere is the pressure equal to 76 centimeter of mercury, which is also equal to 760 millimeter of mercury. And remember, 1 millimeter of mercury is equal to 1 torr. You can convert the units from one to another. Next, gases have indefinite expansibility and they occupy the volume of the container, entire container. Now, volume of the gas is the space occupied by the fixed mass of gas, and its units are liters, or 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube. 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube is equal to 1000 milliliter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, you may be asked in one unit and you may be asked to convert it to another unit. Now, the relationship between these three, by keeping one entity constant, these are the rules which are followed by all the gases. So let us study Boyle's law first. Robert Boyle, he gave the relationship of the pressure of a gas to its volume at a particular temperature. Now, what is the statement? The statement of the Boyle's law goes like this: temperature remaining constant, the volume of a given mass of dry gas is inversely proportional to its pressure. Let me repeat. Temperature remaining constant, the volume of a given mass of dry gas is inversely proportional to its pressure. Now, what Robert Boyle did, he took a piston which was enclosed in three sides, and there was a movable, he took a container and it was covered with a piston on one side, and he took, suppose, carbon dioxide gas, a fixed mass of carbon dioxide gas. Now, this had a volume of V1 initially, and it was at a pressure P1. Now, what he did, and this piston is movable, suppose he pushed the piston inwards and brought the piston to a new position. Suppose this is position A, this is position B. And what happens to the volume? Now, you see the piston, it's compressing the gas molecules, so it comes to a new volume V2. Now, tell me the volume, now it increases or decreases? Obviously, it decreases. Now, he saw that the pressure is increased. Why? Because the same number of gas molecules are compressed, so the chances or the possibilities of the bombardment of the gases on the walls of the container becomes more. Now, come to a third position where the piston is moved outwards to a new position C. He pulls the piston outwards to a new position C. Now, here he found that the volume increased, the mass of the gas remains fixed. It's the same given mass of gas. Now, this becomes V2. Now, he saw that when the volume is increased, the pressure of the gases decreases. That means volume and pressure are inversely related to each other, but that is at a particular temperature T. This whole system, all this whole process was carried out at a particular temperature, suppose 25 degrees Celsius. And then he saw that this change or this inverse relation, it was proportional. That means if the volume is doubled, pressure becomes half. If the volume is half, then the pressure becomes doubled. That is the meaning of inversely proportional. So what he said, P is inversely proportional to V, or P is equal to some constant K times 1 by V. Now, by cross multiplication, P into V is equal to constant at a constant temperature. T should be constant. It's maintained at a particular temperature. So, if a particular mass of gas occupies V1 volume at pressure P1 and volume V2 at pressure P2, then according to Boyle's law, P1 into V1 is equal to P2 into V2. And remember, the temperature has to be constant. T is equal to constant. Now suppose I ask you to plot a graph between the pressure on the x-axis, pressure in suppose centimeter of mercury, or atmospheres. Suppose atmospheres, 1, 2, 3, 4 atmosphere, 5 atmosphere, 6 atmosphere, and volume on the y-axis in ml. Suppose it is 250, 500, 750, 1000, then it will show a graph of inverse relationship, that is like this. So when the volume is maximum, pressure is least. When volume decreases, pressure is maximum. Is it clear? Now let us solve some examples. Suppose we have a gas is allowed to expand at a constant temperature from an initial volume of 300 ml to a final volume of 1200 ml. I repeat the question. Suppose a gas is allowed to expand at a constant temperature from an initial volume of 300 ml to a final volume of 1200 ml. At the end of the expansion, the pressure was found to be 1 atmosphere. At the end of the expansion, that means P2 is 1 atmosphere. What was the initial pressure? We have to find out. This is the question. When I'm calling out, you can even write down, or it's given in the book, you can understand. Now how to solve this? These are the details given. Now applying Boyle's law, we have P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 at constant temperature. So let us put the values. P1 we have to find out. Let's keep it as P1. V1 is 300 is equal to ml is equal to P2, that's 1 atmosphere, into V2, that is 1200 ml. So P1 is equal to 1 atmosphere into 1200 ml divided by 300 ml, that's equal to 4 atmospheres. So we saw when the volume increases to 4 times, the pressure decreases to 1/4, because earlier it was 4 atmospheres and the final one is 1 atmosphere. Now let us solve another problem. A certain mass of carbon dioxide gas occupies 750 cc at a certain pressure. Suppose V1 is 750 cc at a certain pressure, P1, which we have to find out. When the pressure was changed to 2.5 atmospheres, it occupied a volume of 1500 cc. What was the initial pressure if the temperature is kept constant? That's the question. What was the initial pressure if the temperature was kept constant? Now, temperature is constant means we have to apply Boyle's law. Applying Boyle's law, or according to Boyle's law, we have P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So P1 into 1500 cc is equal to P2 2.5 atmospheres into V2 1500 cc. So P1 is equal to 2.5 atmospheres into 15 cc divided by V1 is 750, into 750. So that comes to 5 atmospheres. Answer. Please write the units properly. Let us do another example and then we'll stop. The third example is, a certain volume of a gas was found to be at a pressure of 1200 millimeter of mercury. When the pressure was decreased by 500 millimeter, so what does it say? When the pressure was decreased by 500 millimeter, so P2 will be 1200 minus 500, that's 700 millimeter of mercury. When the pressure was decreased by 500 millimeter, the volume occupied by the gas was V2 was 2400 cc. Calculate the initial volume occupied by the gas if the change was done at a constant temperature. I'm reading out the question once again. Please be attentive. A certain volume of a gas was found to be at a pressure of 1200 millimeter of mercury. When the pressure was decreased by 500 millimeter, the gas occupied a volume of 2400 cc. Calculate the initial volume occupied by the gas if the change was done at a constant temperature. Okay, let us solve this. V1 is equal to initial volume, that is equal to, we have to find out, V2 is this. Now, according to Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 at, of course, T constant. So, let us put the values. P1 into V1 is equal to P2 into V2. So, V1 is equal to 700 into 2400 divided by 1200. That's equal to 1400 cc or centimeter cube. Okay, let's do one more sum and then I'll stop here. In my next video, I'll teach you about Charles' law. What volume will a gas occupy at 750 mm pressure, which at 1480 mm occupies 500 cc, temperature being constant? I repeat, what volume will a gas occupy at 740 mm pressure, which at 1480 millimeter occupies 500 cc? So 500 cc is occupied at 1480 millimeter pressure. So what volume will the gas occupy at 740 millimeter? So applying Boyle's law, we can solve this because temperature remains constant. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So we have 1480 into 500 is equal to 740 into V2, or V2 is 1480 into 500 divided by 740, that's equal to 1000 cc. I hope it's clear, and please try to solve all the problems in Boyle's law. And in my next video, I will take up Charles' law. Thank you. Have a good day.